Get ready for a night of face-melting metal, Friday, November 10th at The Odd in West Asheville. It is the return of the annual Steel and Stone Fest, featuring the only performance of the year from the North Carolina power metal legends, Twisted Tower Dive. The rest of the lineup includes metal bands from Asheville and surrounding areas, Children of the Reptile, Oblivion Throne, Overload, Temptation's Wings, and All Hell. $12 in advance, $15 at the door. First 50 people get a free comp CD. Doors are at 4, the music is at 7. For advance tickets, go to steelandstonefest.com. Be there.
Hey, metalheads, you like tattoos? Of course you do. If you're in the Louisville, Kentucky area, come on over the bridge to Clarksville, Indiana, and get you some ink done at Ageless Art. If ink isn't your thing, they have a piercing studio as well. Visit agelessartclarksville.com to see some frequently asked questions, meet the staff. The shop is open Monday through Thursday, 12 to 8 p.m., Saturdays, 12 to 10 p.m., and Sundays, 12 to 6 p.m., all appointment-only spots. You can set up your appointments by phone at 812-283-1793 or email agelessarttattooandpiercing@gmail.com and someone will get you set up for your first or your next tattoo or piercing. Hey, metalheads. After going to a rager, what's your ultimate go-to? Mine is totally pizza. So when Overload is playing or I'm promoting the Metal Forge live showcases or the big goddamn metal show, I go to Pizza Donisi. Pizza Donisi is gourmet artisan pizza from right here in Louisville, Kentucky. It features things like the pizza of the month, the sandwiches, and also vegetarian and vegan options, which is so totally fucking cool for all of it's awesome pizza. You definitely want to go. Hey, and also from time to time they do cannolis. Oh, so fucking good. You know what they said, man? Leave the gun, take the cannoli. Yeah, just like that in Godfather. They're located right next to the Mag Bar at 1396 South 2nd Street. So either stop in or call in at 502-213-0488. They're open till midnight. The witching hour.
Heineken! Fuck that shit! Pabst Blue Ribbon!
Hey, metalheads, you all hear me talk about Mag Bar all the time. It is the home to the Metal Forge Live showcases and is an integral stop in the ultimate underground metal tour schedule. They obviously feature live music, but the Mag Bar also has daily specials like Pint and Slice Night on Tuesdays with Pizza Donisi. But they also do Bring Your Own Vinyl on Thursdays with DJ Kent Jackson and Finer Things Sundays. Located right next to Pizza Donisi at 1398 South 2nd Street. Open 3 p.m. to 4 a.m. 7 days a week. Get your asses out to the Mag Bar. Rock out. For 45 years in keeping Louisville weird, Electric Ladyland has been there for all your eccentricities. While they do offer the best smoking supplies out on the market today, there's a whole lot more to check out. From ashtrays and blacklight posters, to records, incense and burners, and items to stock your metaphysical supply. They're open from 10 to 10, 7 days a week.
located at 2325 Bardstown Road in Louisville, Kentucky, and at electricladyland420.com. Roll out.
In a broken wasteland, I come to my fire. I place your blood and steel upon my pyre. Oh, this is the mental force. This is the mental force. This is the mental force. This is the
What is going on, metalheads? Thank you all for tuning into this week's episode of The Metal Forge. My name is Mark Jackson, and I am your host, and I have ransacked Jason Gardner again this week, because he just gave me a look of so much malcontent, like, you motherfucker, what are you doing to me? Hi, Jason.
Yeah, man, we're just doing some Steel and Stone stuff here, and you just... change the subject on me clearly, but what's going on?
No, this is not changing the subject on you, because this is the Metal Forge. This is all about steel and fucking stone now, not the big goddamn metal show, not until next year.
Next October.
Yeah, maybe. We'll see. But no, this is about steel and stone and all of the cool shit that's going to be going on there with Ricky's Hot Chicken Shack and Children of the Reptile coming to fuck that place up.
Hopefully, yeah. I mean, like I said, I've got ideas out there. A little bit of hospitality for some of the bands, and not the locals, of course, because we live here. But the other town bands need a little something. So
hell yes.
I was trying to find some stuff. I was talking to the booking agent about the the band perks, if they're still the same, so I can let everybody know. Something like that. So just trying to get all the last minute details in order so we can start this last push for the last 2 weeks to go.
Definitely, because we only want premium hookers and blow in our dressing room.
Oh, we're in the wrong town for that, man. There's no premium hookers here in this town.
I'm sure there are.
No.
I have low standards, Jason. I'm a metalhead. I have low fucking standards.
I consider us friends, and I wouldn't do that.
She'll be like the chick in Breaking Bad, wouldn't she? Who looks like a really trashed out Courtney Cox, I think.
I mean, that would probably be a step up from what we have to offer here in town.
Yes.
I actually know for a lot of things. It's prostitutes, or quality of prostitutes is definitely not one of them.
God damn, man.
I don't even know where they're at anymore. Like, I used to know like part of town they were in just because you like work, but I was working with companies and stuff. I was like all over the place, and you would see them and stuff, just happenstance. But I still work all over town, but I have no idea where they're at. Like, they just kind of migrate. I don't know where they go, and I really don't care. It's just like the town's pretty small, so you should be able to see them.
What's that they say in Tommy Boy? That's when the whores come in. something like that.
Yeah, but we are in the. I think we're in the whore-free district. Town. So
okay.
Should be safe. Yeah.
I have heard some interesting stories about Peter Steele there, right?
Yeah. So I played at the Orange Peel after Peter Steele played there, and I sat on the couch where he was serviced by two ladies, and he actually held the show until he got done with what he needed to get done. I was like sitting like in the aura of greatness, but it's probably sitting in something else after I thought about it.
Yeah, so it's now called the Orange Steel. fuck yeah, man. So this week we have one of your last month album picks on the Metal Forge. We have Jonathan from Graveyard here soon. So what the fuck is up, man? I mean, you turned me onto this album, and I've been spinning it like nonstop. I really enjoy it. It's such a kick-ass album.
Very 70s. I will say though, this album, after many listens, I think the His Sage and Blues album is still my top out of their discography.
Right.
Say like 2011 or 12. But yeah, it's good. I mean, like I said, they don't veer off the path very much. They're kind of like AC/DC, you know, and it's like you know what you're getting every time they put an album out.
I think we talk about that is, you know, that's not a bad quality. It's dependability.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, like, I don't fault bands for not changing. I mean, look, the thing is, like, everyone's like, well, you got to change it up every album to evolve. I'm like, well, do you really, though? Because, I mean, what are you changing up? It's still these notes you're playing. You know, it's production can be different, but, I mean, at the core of everything, it's still music. So what are you really changing?
Right. And, you know, there's the thing of where you have bands that just go too far off the path.
Yeah.
And then they completely alienate fan bases. Yeah. And then they try to come back to it. And then it's not the same. Yeah. So, yeah, there's a ton of different things out there. And I think, you know, go to the edge of what you feel is your limit. And you know, always push your limit is what I would say, rather than change it up every album. Just push your limit.
Yeah. And I mean, until a band or an artist finds that eight musical key, everyone's kind of playing the same parameters.
Yeah, you know? Absolutely. Before we get into listening to some Graveyard, which you're going to pick today, so fuck yeah, I want to ask you, this is your 7th year putting on a festival.
Mm-hmm.
Out of 7 years of doing this, what is the one thing that has stayed the same?
Dude, I'll be honest with you, the idea is still the same. So I've gotten bigger bands to play it, obviously with 19 playing the year before, and I've had Alan Giant on, and the band Cloak, if you're not familiar with them.
And Twisted Tower.
Afterwards, now I've Twisted Tower this year, which is like, I wouldn't say they're on the rise, but they're like the grandfathers of power metal, because they were doing it back in the 90s and no one was doing it. So, yeah, but I would say it's just like the feel of just keeping it like, let's find the coolest 100 people to come in and celebrate underground music.
Fuck yeah, man.
That's it. Like, I don't care about like having a write up in like this magazine or that magazine. I just do a little bit of radio press, you know, local radio. I use local bands to help, you know, promote the show. I use local bands that would fit well with the headliner. I've always done 3 locals, 3 regional / out of town bands, and yeah, it's been the same every year, basically.
Fuck yeah, dude.
Yeah, I don't like bite off more than I can chew or want to chew. I mean, yeah, I've had ideas about expanding it like 2 nights or whatever, but as I've explained to Mark before, a lot of the venues around here, the parking situation's a nightmare. So it's really hard to have multiple bands play when it's like street parking. Or like an alleyway that only fits like one van or like 2 cars, and you know, and someone's pulling a trailer, then you gotta like get the road blocked all day, and you know, it's just like it's a big mess. So the auditorium, or the odd now, has a parking lot, and that's why I use them every year, because the load-in's relatively simple, the parking lot's sufficient, it's in a good location, and everyone knows that there's metal there, so they're looking for metal. All they gotta do is pretty much just look to see who's playing at night and
come the fuck out.
Sometimes that's the only option in town for metal, so you know, it works out well. But yeah, so yeah, I mean, just like I said, just like keep it simple, stupid.
Fuck yeah, yeah. The KISS mentality. Fuck yeah, man, absolutely. And what are we gonna listen to from Graveyard today, dude?
We are going with Ain't Fit to Live Here from His Sinage and Blues, because I talked about it.
Hell yeah.
This is my first introduction. I saw him with Opeth at the Orange Peel here in Nashville. So, yeah, I've always been a fan ever since.
And you know, dude, I ain't fit to leave here.
I don't know.
I got no friends. Only people that I know.
right, metalheads, this week is awesome because if you listened back to the September episode of the Metal Forge albums edition, you would find that Jason Gardner from the Heavy Metal Wasteland, in his two picks, one of them was with Graveyard. And we have Jonathan here today from Graveyard, all the way from, where are you at today? Are you at home in like Sweden?
Yeah. No, it's daytime here, or it's in the evening right now. So I'm just hanging out with my, I have two small boys that's, they're having their soccer training right now, but it's kind of nice weather still here. It's getting cold, but you know.
Yeah, this week, and like I said, by the time we're recording this versus the time that this airs, it's still been like around 85 degrees Fahrenheit here around the Louisville area. So this weekend is supposed to be the first real cold weekend where it's going to be around the 60 to 65 Fahrenheit. And it's, oh, I love it. I love this time of year once it starts to get cool and kind of cold around the Halloween season, the fall time, because I don't know about there, because where we are here, we kind of have what they call false spring and false fall. It's where it gets cold for like 2 weeks, and then it heats right back up again for like another month.
All right.
Kind of a fake deal.
It's the first one.
Yeah, Mother Nature really, really kind of screws us on that and says, oh, wait, nope, not yet. So, Jason had talked about your latest album, number 6, which actually had come out at the very end of September. It was interesting because by the time we had done the review of the album, the show released the day the album came out. And all right, you know, all right. Huge shout outs to Nuclear for sending me an advanced copy so we could actually do a review. And now have you here as well.
Oh yeah, that's good timing.
It was the greatest. So walk me through, because earlier today you all posted some really cool studio pictures and stuff where you're messing with the tape and everything.
I love that.
I
just saw it really right before you called. I think Truls had some pictures from the studio kind of that we forgot about, you know. So it's always nice to have something.
Yeah, there's nice to have visuals that go with it versus going back and just being able to listen to it. With the visuals, you never know. It might capture something that you were like, I wonder how we did that. And somebody just so happened to snap a picture and it's like, I wonder what we're doing here. So going back on a little bit of a history with Graveyard here, you all started in 2006, had a 10-year run, and then kind of split up but reformed within the next year.
It was a short hiatus.
Okay.
But, you know, we just, in 2016 or 15, was it 16 maybe? Yeah. We came to a point where we couldn't really, you know, get along as good, you know. So it was a rough time, but I think we managed to get the best possible solution for it, you know. So we're very happy to be back and not having the same issues anymore.
Right, because hey, I know everybody says that being in a band is like being in a marriage or a relationship, and yeah, it kind of is, but yeah, when people are just not jiving with one another, it's rough. And it can really be bad and, you know, tumultuous, and I just don't, I guess in my life right now, I don't want to be that guy, you know.
Yeah,
it's like I just I look back on times with other people like that and say, you know, I wish I could have done better. But hey, yep. But here you are 6 years later putting out a new album again, you know, another album. And it's heavy, but it's, I like it. And so tell everybody out in Metal Forge Land about the sixth album.
We started writing new material kind of early, but we weren't, I think before the pandemic, we had maybe two song ideas maybe. And we mostly worked on the songs after the pandemic and the shutdown and all. So I think that's why it's kind of, you know, it's a little more melancholy maybe, and it's a little I think it's somehow it's inspired by the situation, you know. But we write, everybody is writing, and sometimes we bring a pretty much you know, a song, a whole song, and sometimes we just bring some kind of idea or a riff or, you know, something to work on together. So it's very different, but yeah. And then we have Tom Alsterberg, the producer and sound engineer. He's been working very much with the songs, and, you know, he likes to take things apart and put it back together, and it takes a while, but it turns out really good, you know. He's very talented. So we've been working on this one, it feels like a long time now, but it's been sitting around for a couple, maybe 9 months.
Oh, since, wow.
Just waiting around as well. So
yeah, it's been done for happy. That long.
Yeah, almost. You know, it's been a while now, but then we kept on missing a couple of deadlines, you know.
Right, because of the record pressing.
No one really knew, you know, no one really expected it to be done by then. But, you know, it's been, you know, we had the pleasure of, you know, kind of waiting out the good part, you know. So it's,
for sure,
very happy to have it out, yeah.
Definitely. And when you all do, so, okay, the difference between, like, here versus up there kind of upper echelon type band and stuff, when it comes to production of the product, say, okay, we know we're going to do it on vinyl, we know we're going to do CD, cassette, etc. these days, when it goes into, like, are you, like, seriously crunching the numbers of what you should do and how many of things that you should press, or is that going to be, like, a complete label thing?
Yeah, it's mostly just a label, and I guess maybe our management is involved with that, but mostly just the record labels. You
okay.
Know? And they have done a great job so far. So.
And that's great, because that lets you not have to worry about, okay, are we gonna, if we're gonna press, say, 50,000 copies of something, are they gonna be sitting around, you know, versus just, okay,
yeah,
you guys handle this part, I'll handle this part, and
yeah,
and hey,
it's good for us. Yeah, I think that's good for everyone that's doing music, not to have the business and or the numbers, as you say, in the mind all the time, because it takes a lot of energy and focus off what's, you know, what it should be.
Exactly. So with the new album six, what is your favorite track from it?
Oh, that's a hard one. It's always hard to know before you play them live, I feel like, you know, because that's when you realize which ones really or the most fun to do, you know. To just listen to, I think Good Nut is a good song, and I also like Bright Lights, the second single we released. And I mean, I enjoy all of them, of
right,
course, but it's more of a you know, how fun they are to do live, or you know.
Definitely. I think you're right on that, because it's kind of like when you get asked that question, it's like trying to pick your favorite child. And you can't pick a favorite, you know. At least I couldn't. But the thing is like, yeah, it really determines on like if you like playing something live. If it has good energy and it feels good to play it, and people, the audience out there are into it, then yeah, it is a fun song at that point. It is a favorite song.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
So out of the recording process, there's always times, I think, where we have to just disconnect and say, okay, this is, I don't want to say good enough, because that's kind of an adding like, I would change it if I could. But is there anything on the new album that you personally would say, I might change this if I ever had the chance to go back? Or is it still too new?
I think it's a little too new, but at the same time, throughout, you know, the concerts or live shows, I always change things, you know, a little bit now and then. But it's and if you come up with something really, you know, something that you like, you just maybe keep on doing it for a while, and then I forget another part and I play something else, and it's more it's a little, I think it's nice with the, you know, with a kind of slow songs, that you have a little more space to improvise and do things a little differently,
for sure,
you know.
Well, I know from being a musician myself, the adaptation of and the fluidity of your music over time, where you might find what might be an easier way to play something than how you wrote it originally.
Yeah,
which I think is always cool, which I was, months ago, I was talking with Brian Tatler of Diamond Head, and he said that same thing. He's like, yeah, you know, he's like, I just might find something, some way, and I'm paraphrasing. He's like, it might just feel easier, feel better on my hands to play something a certain way versus, you know, I might have written it young and I played a lot clunkier back then. And wow, you know, it's like, I think that's interesting that that's something as musicians that we all kind of do.
Yeah, I agree. I think it's... it's needed, you know. It's finding new ways. It's always more fun, I feel like.
And what I've always thought is, like, seeing people out in the audience when you might change something a little bit different, and like the diehard fan knows that you might have changed it, and they're like, because like they play it, and then they're like, they're jumping up and looking like, wait a minute, that's different, which I like, especially when you like do music videos, like Breathe In, Breathe Out's video is great. I just love, like, I love black and white anyways. So,
Me too, man.
Before we switch over here, like I said, your time is limited. My time's a little bit limited today. So we'll have to get a nice long form out eventually. With the new tour process, are you all planning on doing U.S. dates as well?
Yeah, for sure. The plan is to just, you know, visit pretty much everywhere where we've been earlier. We'll definitely come back to the U.S. as well, but we don't have a set date for it, you know.
Okay.
But hopefully in a soon.
So one other question on that, because this revolves to the touring thing. A lot of times in this day and age, a lot of musicians still have to keep a day job. I do. I know a ton of others that do. I would assume that you do as well.
Yeah, I mean, we had to start working with this flu, you know, the COVID shutdown. So we all had to either work part-time or full-time. So, yeah, but hopefully, all of us miss the the old age now.
Right, and not having to.
Hopefully we can get going, you know, get this band rolling again, and we'll be back full time.
So. For sure.
Yeah.
Well, that was going to be one of the question I would ask is, because there's a bunch of, like, higher echelon bands out there. I try not to mention their names because I feel like bands like you deserve more press and attention than these bands that have been that are in their 50s and 60s and 70 year olds still playing music today.
Yeah, right.
Granted, I love a lot of them, but it's kind of time to move over. It's kind of time to move over for some of them. But do you ever like have the time to where you can take like the kids on a tour or something, like especially if you're going across Europe or something, or to the States? Is there a way have you all ever done that, you know, take like the family and it, let the kids experience the culture of other countries and stuff?
That would be great if we could do that more often, you know. We had, whenever Axel was in the band that played the drums, he sometimes brought his boy with us on the bus, you know, in Europe and sometime in the US as well. And I think it's great, you know, when everybody thinks it's great to have kids around. So it's really no problem. It's more of a, you know, logistic question, you know, with all the...
Because it's an extra mouth to feed on tour as well.
Sorry,
it's an extra mouth to feed on tour, and if you're playing venues in America that have an age requirement of 21, that a thing over there? Do you all have all your shows like a certain age and up, or what?
Yeah, I think it's 13. You have to be at least 13 years, but then you can, you know, if you go with your mom or dad, and then otherwise you have to be 20 or 18, I think.
Okay, right on. That's interesting. I never knew that over there, because I've never been overseas yet. So I say yet.
All right.
I say yet.
Oh yeah.
All right.
Someday soon.
Because we're limited for time, I'm going to go ahead and switch over here to the derailed segment. These are five random questions about you as a person, and anytime you're ready, we can get started.
All right, yeah, we can just go ahead.
Is human potential capable of anything?
I think so, yeah.
Right on. Yeah, if whatever you put your mind to, you can achieve. For the most part, I mean, there is some psycho stuff going on.
I mean, everybody's, you know, we all have different, you know, obstacles or whatever, or But if you put your mind into something and you just make your mind up, I think anyone can achieve anything, really.
Definitely.
I hope so.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Have you ever traveled anywhere just for the cuisine?
No.
There was the food question. See, I told you would have one. Like, did you travel to Germany I don't know. I don't want to be stereotypical and say something like sauerkraut or anything, but you know what I'm saying. Like for some German, like a Rouladen, you know, would you just for that?
Oh, yeah. No, I wish I had, but I haven't actually done that. But, you know, maybe there's time to still do that. But I'm very fond of sauerkraut otherwise. Might have been an option for me.
Yeah, right. What is something that you used to do that makes you cringe now?
That was such a long time ago. But when I was a kid and growing up, I think I tried to be a little more tough than I really was, you know.
Okay.
But otherwise, I can't come up with anything, even though there's a bunch of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
That I,
yeah, for sure.
You know,
yeah, but I think we all kind of do that when we're younger. We all kind of have the chest pump up thing. And Yeah. And being a heavy musician, you know, the testosterone really kicks in, and you're just, you know, adrenaline starts to flow, as some band used to say in a song. There's so much out there today that is just everything's going. There's TV, there's internet, there's what is your major distraction?
I would say, even though I don't spend that much time on my phone or, you know, on television, but when I do, I feel like it's still too much, you know.
Right. Like this, so, 20 minutes, we're 20 minutes in, and you're probably like, wow, this is really long. No.
No problem, man. I'm just looking for some shoes in between here.
Nice, nice. But I do have one more question, and I'll let you go for the day. But before we do, links are listed below, so please give a like, a share, and a follow. Go buy merch. Go find these awesome dudes on tour when they decide that tour is a thing and they're going to come to wherever you are. Go see them because they deserve it and they kick ass. Again, Graveyard 6 came out on the last Friday. I believe it was Friday the 29th of September. Do you have any shout to anybody you want to give today?
Shout out to anyone?
Yeah.
Did you say that?
Yeah.
Yeah, man. I mean, without everybody that's listening to us or buying our records or you know, coming to our shows, we owe you a big time, and we're very happy and thankful, you know. And you know, yeah, you're very important.
Definitely. And I personally, before we go, I want to give a shout out to Austin for setting this up. He's a cool dude. Yeah. And just a big thank you to him. So my final question of the day is, what kind of person do you see yourself being in 5 years?
I see myself maybe sitting outside after getting home from a tour, maybe even a couple of more records within that time, you know, until then. So that's what I hope for, you know.
Definitely. Dude, that is awesome. That, like, you know, and hopefully with the two kids at soccer practice, you might be being that dad in the box up in the thing at the arena watching the kids play soccer when you've reached an age of retirement or whatever, as it were. You can watch the kids play soccer professionally.
Yeah. Yeah, that sounds good.
Dude, that's awesome. That would be so much fun to, I don't, in America, we have so many parents that like live through their children that like, oh, I used to play football. You're going to play football too. And it's I kind of see it, but I'm like, ah, but I want to be a musician, dad.
I know. We have those, that kind of, parents here.
Oh,
too,
you do,
sure.
As well? Wow. And where they're constantly like, it almost feels like they're forcing their kids to do it.
I agree. You know, come on. You know, it should be fun, you know. It's, they're too young.
I agree with that 100%. Yeah. Dude, Jonathan, thank you so much for coming on the Metal Forge this week.
Thank you.
I appreciate everything, and I am looking forward to new music again already, and it's so new, but I'm already looking forward to it. And what is the song that you want to play out from the new album today?
I would like to play maybe Rampant Fields.
Awesome. You heard him, everybody. Here it goes.
I need and more, let it go. Someday I might say I know what it's like. While I'm passing by through Amberfield, yes, I see your golden bar. I cast my sorrow just a little too far. The splinter in my mind won't move at all. Fog is a cover and the nightmare was no dream. Oh no, it was.
In 2017, one man's vision and passion for all things metal started out as a record store in his house. Years later, the fight against a mainstream empire continues as Shade Beast. an independent metal collective and online store based in Athens, Georgia, is the world's premier heavy metal brand for music heads that value authenticity over the mainstream acceptance. Featuring original t-shirts from some of the best underground artists, as well as stickers, posters from the Shade Beast Presents concert series. Unique, one-of-a-kind collectibles and small curated selection of vinyl and cassettes from the masters old and new. Visit ShadeBeast.com and enter promo code SITHLORD for free domestic shipping on your first order, whether you're a new customer or returning. And be sure to join the Shade Beast social groups on Facebook and the interwebs to keep up with the new release announcements and talk all things metal and Star Wars. You'll never find a more wretched hive of scum and filth.
Welcome to the night. You think you know Night Demon? Then the Night Demon Heavy Metal Podcast is for you. Step into the darkness as we peel back the curtain to give you an unprecedented, all-access look into the mind and the heart of the demon. We're talking band history, song analysis, studio anecdotes, stories from the road. It's everything a diehard Night Demon fan could want and more. This is the only place to learn the inside scoop, the deep dive trivia, the untold tales from the band members themselves and those closest to the Night Demon story. Need more? The sacred Night Demon crypt will be pried open to reveal demo recordings that have never before seen the light of day, all with in-depth commentary by the band and the people who were there for the writing and recording process. This is a gold mine, a treasure trove of all things Night Demon. Head over to nightdemon.net. or wherever you listen to podcasts.
Since 2013, there has been a calling from the underground, from the graves of all those unholy, and they decided to make a zine to talk about all of this. Soul Grinder Zine, an independent metal zine to keep you informed on all things metal and horror from the underground. Available in both print and digital formats, they're bringing you the best interviews and reviews out there today. Not only do they do the zine, but they also do compilation CDs. Check them out at facebook.com/soulgrinder.zine and start your subscription now.
Hey everybody, let me tell you about the new sponsor to the Metal Forge, Unchained Tapes. They're an independent Pennsylvania tape label. They focus on extreme metal and punk with a killer approach to the tape scene. Visit their web store at unchainedtapes.bigcartel.com now to get your fill of tapes. And for being a Metal Forge listener, enter the code METALFORGE10 at checkout to get a 10% discount on your total purchase. That's unchainedtapes.bigcartel.com. BigCartel.com.
What's up, Metal Forge fans? This is Alan Bishop, the alchemist of Indiana's Black Forest and head distiller at Spirits of French Lick. Do you find yourself drawn to the unexplained, fascinated by the Fortean, or enchanted by the paranormal? If the things that go bump in the night resonate in your mind, then tune into my brand new podcast, If You Have Ghosts, You Have Everything. Featuring firsthand accounts, collected stories, interviews, history, and speculation related to all things not of this world. Available now on Anchor, Spotify, Google, Amazon, and more. Set back, relax, and remember, if you have ghosts, you have everything.
Hey, let me tell you guys about Mercenary Press. They're an independent London label and distributor of all things metal. Mercenary Press delivers the goods from their own independent zine. Trust me, you're going to want to get in on that. To distributing various bands from all over the world, including Cramp from Spain and Sadistic Force from Texas. Visit mercenarypress.bigcartel.com to find out what all they have in stock and what you can order. And for Metal Forge listeners, enter code MetalForge10 to receive a discount on your total purchase at mercenarypress.bigcartel.com. Check it out now.
Hey, Metalheads, it's with great pleasure I get to tell you guys about a new sponsor to the Metal Forge, Ageless Art, New Albany. After 20 years of owning and operating Ageless Art in Clarksville, Indiana, Phil Garrett had a vision for a new type of tattoo studio. Something that is clean and modern, sleek, refined, inviting. And he's done just that with Ageless Art in New Albany. You can find it at 2736 Charlestown Road, New Albany, Indiana, 47150. Business hours are Monday through Saturday, 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. Sundays are 12 to 6. All sessions are appointment only, so give them a call and go get you some new ink. Or if it's your first time, go get your first one, baby. Maxwell's House of Music in Jeffersonville, Indiana is the premier 12,500 square foot music superstore that has served both Southern Indiana and Louisville, Kentucky metro area for over four decades. Originally founded by Marvin and Beverly Maxwell in the 70s, this gym remains a Maxwell family-owned business. Mark Maxwell, along with his business partner Whitney McNichol, continued the reputation as being the national resource for all things music.
In 2022, the iconic Guitar Emporium of Louisville relocated to Maxwell's Music, creating the largest independently owned showroom in the region. The retail offerings at Maxwell's Music includes a huge selection of guitars, basses, amplifiers, effects pedals, modeling amps, keyboards, drums, banjos, mandolins, ukuleles, sound systems, stage lighting equipment, and accessories. The music education program at Maxwell's is second to none. From private instrument and voice lessons to DJ, EDM, recording, songwriting, and music theory, to Rock School, Weekend Warriors, and Maxwell's Music Lab, there is something for every age and every ability level.
Down in repair land, guitar and instrument repairs and refurbishment are taken care of by the Maxwell's team of expert guitar technicians and luthiers. They also do appraisals of instruments as well. Maxwell's offers installations for professional audio, visual, and lighting systems for schools, churches, clubs, VFWs, funeral homes, sports fields, and so much more. There's also rentable space at Maxwell's, from the music practice and rehearsal rooms for the individuals and bands, all the way to a meeting space and concert venue that seats up to 120. That also includes a professional audio, visual, and lighting system and a sound booth. Maxwell's has it all. All this plus original functioning 1947 recording booth to make your own record. Go to the Guitar Hero Throne, to the very own Elvis statue, and don't forget the Harmony Green Pocket Park. There's a reason the Maxwell's House of Music in Jeffersonville, Indiana has been recognized by the National Association of Music Merchants as a number one award-winning best store design, as well as top 100 music store year after year. You gotta see it to believe it. Maxwell's House of Music in Jeffersonville, Indiana.